guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I am 34 weeks pregnant with baby girl. I cannot believe it's literally like 6 weeks away to her due date. I honestly do not think that she is going to last that long, just from all the symptoms and things that I've been having. So I want to dive on into this video because it is going to be a short video for you guys. There's not a whole lot I can talk about because there's not a whole lot of change, honestly. But what has changed is, so we had a scare, like false labor scare, happen on Saturday. Yeah, Saturday morning around 10 o'clock. I was putting my makeup on and things like that and just getting ready for the day. My husband was outside with the baby, mowing the grass and doing yard work. I said, hey, I'm gonna run to the store real quick. I gotta grab a few things. And the store is literally, I don't know, like 5-8 minutes away from here. So it's really like a hop, skip, and a jump over the road here. So I took off down the road and it was like 10:30. And I started having these severe cramps, like these intense cramps as if you're about to start your period, right? So I didn't think too much about it because I was like, whatever, you know, you have cramping when you're pregnant. It's no big deal. Like, it's part of the process, you know what I mean? So, but the whole time I'm in the store, they got a little bit worse, but yet bearable at the same time. Now, let me just add, I was induced with my son at 38 weeks and 3 days. Had him 38 weeks and 4 days. So he was induced 11 days early, had him 10 days early. So I didn't get the natural feeling of what labor feels like. So that, therefore, I didn't recall this, like, I figured that this would go away. You know what I mean? Like, I figured if I am starting to be in labor and things are progressing, then these cramps will get more intense and then they'll turn into other things and da-da-da-da-da, that type of thing. Well, then I started feeling my stomach contract. She would get really, really hard and it would last for a little bit and then it would be like a 2-second break, but then it'd get hard again. So it was not literally something that I could sit there and track or anything like that, if that's what you guys are thinking. So anyways, long and short of all of that, I come home, I unload the groceries. I had a big old watermelon in my hand and I was just like, cause I was craving it really bad. So that's another reason I had to go to the store. And so I was sitting there and I was just like, I'm gonna drop this watermelon cause I'm cramping. I've gotta bend over, like I'm hurting. I didn't tell my husband, put that on him and make him worry, okay? Well, a little while goes on and then it got so severely bad. I was in the living room with my son, just me and him, and he kept wanting me to play with him and like do something. And he kept throwing something in my lap. He's like, play, play, play. And I said, no, buddy, I couldn't even look at him. And I was like going, no, buddy, I can't do it. Like I was trying my hardest to get through this pain. And it was weird because I have a high pain tolerance, but this was just like intense. It was, I don't want to over exaggerate it, but it was intense for me. I was just like, what is this? It hurts so bad. So a little while went on and I finally told my husband, I said, I don't feel right. I just don't feel right. And then I started getting very nauseous, very sick. So I went to the bathroom and there was a string of blood, like red blood, like you just got cut, not some old blood that's been there. So I was like, okay, that's not a lot of blood, but it is there. That's never happened before. So I come back out and I told my husband, this is what happened. I need to call my mom, have her come pick up the baby in a little while, just in case we do have to go to labor and delivery. So a couple hours go by, my mom comes and grabs the baby. This pain is still going. I would lay down on the couch or lay down in the bed, try to take a nap. I'd do several different things. Some things took an ease, like it eased off the pain a little bit, but it would never go away. There was no breaks in between these cramps. It was just like a solid cramp, okay? If that makes any sense at all, it was just a solid cramp and it hurt to walk. My belly hurt, you know what I mean? Not my vagina, but my belly really hurt. So then a little while goes on and I contacted my midwife and they're like, please go to labor and delivery so we can monitor and see what's going on with baby. Note, she was still moving. This entire time she was still moving. So that made me think, okay, everything's gonna be okay. She's moving still. They say that, you know, once you start to get into labor and things like that, baby will slow down or stop moving altogether. So that was good. But at the same time, all the other symptoms were like preterm labor, and that made me really, really nervous. So finally it was like 10:30 at night, and I was like, I just couldn't take it anymore, and I had to pee. So I went to the bathroom, and there was drops of blood, and I told my husband, I was like, I feel like if we wait any longer, I'm gonna get a flood of blood and things are gonna go bad, you know? And I said, honestly, I'll be completely honest with you. You know your body. You can even tell things that are off when you're pregnant, when you're further along in pregnancy. But I could not pinpoint what was going on until that minute it struck me. I bet I got a UTI. Just a plain Jane UTI, normal reproductive thing or whatever you want to call it, a UTI. I haven't had a UTI since before my son, right? It did not burn when I peed, anything like that. The only signs were those cramps where I was hurting and the little drops of blood and stuff. But then I also noticed that my pee, because I drink a lot of water, is kind of clear, started to get darker as the hours went. And I was just like, that's backwards. That's not how it's supposed to work, right? So I was like, I think there's something up. I really do think I have a UTI. So we go to the labor and delivery at 11:30 at night. All of my cramps, you guys, went away. Soon as we walked in the door, I just looked at my husband three times on the way there. I said, I'm fine. It's no big deal. Let's just turn back. It's no big deal. Like, I'm fine. I just think that I'm just pregnant and hormonal, whatever. I'm fine. And he kept saying, no, that's not going to happen. So when we got there, she told me to pee in a cup. And I told her what I think it was. I'm not a doctor, not a nurse. I'm not anything like that. But I know my body. And so I was like, I think I have a UTI. And she said, well, honey, if you have a UTI, sometimes that makes your bladder, which is next to your uterus, it will like push up against your uterus and make you contract and things like that. And if it does not get treated, it could turn into something bad. So I was like, okay, well, I think that's what it is. My pee is getting darker. This is blood, da, 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 da. So I peed in the cup, and she looked at it and she's like, it doesn't really look like something that would be, I would think of you having a UTI. She goes, but we'll just test it and find out. And I was like, okay. 3 hours later, she comes back in the room and she goes, okay, so you do, and you've got to take two different kinds of medicine, 7 pills a day. We've got to get rid of this, like, before it gets too bad. So I was like, okay, you know, I was right. So that was good to know that it was false. I was not in labor, but I was having the symptoms of pre-labor. So that made me feel really good to know that she was okay. I was hooked up to the monitor the entire time. They gave me this antibiotic, and I'm still on it. I have 2 more days left of it, and this was Saturday, so it's been almost a week of antibiotics. And then they gave me this medicine that's like, it numbs your bladder, okay? That's what they said. It basically numbs your bladder, so it doesn't take the pain away that I was having. Within 2 days, that was basically cleared up. But with that being said, when it numbed my bladder, like, I wouldn't really realize when I had to pee. So when I'd go to the bathroom, it was like 2 gallons of water that would come out. And at one point in the middle of the night, I thought my water broke because there was so much fluid coming out, so much pee coming out. I was like, oh my gosh, because it just like numbs your bladder. So you don't really know when you need to go to the bathroom. So, but anywho, that was our false labor experience, scary moment. Praise God that nothing happened. Baby girl is still doing good. She is in go position, but she's got a ways to drop, so we are good. I did go to the doctor on Friday. I don't know if I vlogged this part or not, maybe not, but I did go to the doctor on Friday, and I did get an ultrasound. And so last Friday, a week from today, I was 33 weeks, and she was measuring 5 pounds, 2 ounces. And measuring 35 weeks and 3 days. So she's almost 2.5 weeks ahead of her game, which is fine because I'm used to that with my son. He was an 8-pound baby, so and he was almost 2 weeks early. So I kind of figured she was going to be on the bigger side, but they were looking at her ultrasound, and they were like, has anybody told you how long this baby is? And I was like, well, no. And they said, she is pretty darn long. And I was like, okay, well, there's tall people that run in our family. I'm tall. My husband's tall. So I don't know how big she's going to be. Long as she's healthy, I'm doing great. You know what I mean? I also got to look at her hair through an ultrasound, and it has grown so much. Like, she's got hair all the way around, and my son had hair on the sides and the back. So I'm wondering if she's going to have a lot of hair. If she doesn't, it's okay. That's what cute bows are for. But I don't know. I can't, it's like, it would be so cool to have a baby that had a lot of hair, but at the same time, I can't fully picture it because me and my husband didn't come out with a full head of hair. We had hair, but not like a full head of hair. You know what I mean? So I don't know. It would just be a shock to me. But anywho, she's still right up into my placenta. She actually was sucking on my placenta. I talked about that in my last video. But, you know, everything looks great. I go to the doctor a week from today at my 35 weeks. And then after that, I start going once a week until she's here. So everything is looking pretty dang good. Other than that false labor scare, you know, everything is. So I went online on my social media and I asked all my girlfriends or whatever. I was just like, you know, I have severe acid reflux and heartburn with this baby. Like, I'm not used to this. With my son, I had it for like 2 weeks and it was fine. It was something doable, just chewed Tums. It was fine. But with this baby, I feel just grossly sick when I eat anything. So I was really, really like, I need help. I want a tea. I want an herbal tea that I have, that has no caffeine in it, and that I can drink before I go to bed that could help me because it was keeping me up at night. So all my girlfriends were on there and they're like, you know, sleepy time tea would be really good for night and things like that. And then the lemon ginger tea. So I've been drinking that, and for the first 3 or 4 days of drinking like the lemon ginger tea, it had cleared it up so well for me. It did so, so good. It's back. It is back 100%. And it is terrible. Oh, it is so terrible. Every night I'm chewing like 3 or 4 times, like at 1 o'clock in the morning. It's so gross, but I don't know. They say that, you know, when you have severe heartburn and things like that, it means your baby's gonna have a lot of hair. I think that's a old wives' tale, but if it's true, I'm so giving birth to a Chewbacca. I'm not kidding you. I really think that's gonna happen. I am suffering majorly from restless leg syndrome. And I talked about that in a previous video before, that my grandmother had it, my mom has it, I have it, even not even being pregnant. But it is so bad that every single night, it takes me 2 to 3 hours to even fall asleep. And it's mainly on my left leg. My left leg is the main one, but now, like as of last night, it was both legs. So it jumps back and forth, but that is definitely something that has changed. I wanna say within the past 2 to 3 weeks, it has gotten worse. And then this past week, insomnia has kicked in 100%. I can't sleep. I cannot turn my mind off. It's like I'm so tired. You know, you start getting that tired headache. Like, I'm so tired, I'm ready to go to sleep. And I'm like, okay, anytime now, just fall asleep. But I haven't been able to master falling asleep yet, even taking like the sleepy time tea. I wonder if I could take melatonin. I used to take that forever ago. It didn't work a whole lot, but I wonder if it'd work a lot now. I could totally ask my doctor. If any of you girls have any kind of advice, please drop it down below, like as soon as you see this video, because I'm in desperate need. Mama needs some sleep. Nesting has kicked in. On 4th of July, you know how you have like barbecues and cookouts and fireworks and things like that? Oh, no, no, no. Mm-mm. I painted all the baseboards in my house, except for the bedrooms, playroom, oh, and dining room. So I did the living room baseboards, the kitchen, three hallways. And then we did painted side molding, painted door frames, me and my husband. And then we put in the bottom molding around the living room and three hallways. That's what my 4th of July consisted of. I just had this, I want to get this done. And then like right now, I just flipped the top mattress. We'll not be doing that again during this pregnancy, but I literally did that like 30 minutes ago. Cause I like to flip it every so often, but I flipped it and I told my husband, won't be doing that again. He's about to scold me over that. But did that. Oh, and then I went through my entire closet, you guys. 6 bags of clothes. 4 went to Goodwill, 2 went to the trash because ain't nobody want that crap. You know what I mean? So I would say nesting is kind of there, but then whenever I'm feeling really, really nauseous, which is still in full swing right now, I just want to be lazy. However, I know I need to get things done. So, but I am starting to document a lot of things when it comes to breastfeeding. Like I want to make the cookies, the nursing cookies and the bites and the smoothies, and go ahead and have a lot of those in the freezer and things like that, so it's easy to access those whenever I need them later on down the road. So I am thinking about doing that within the next week or so. So a week from tomorrow, I have my baby shower. I'm super excited about it. I'm super excited to see a bunch of my girlfriends and my family. Just a little girl's brunch here at the house. So it should be really fun. But other than that, you guys, that is the biggest things that have been going on. Baby girl is doing great. I am excited to meet her, but extremely nervous about the whole process. But hey, it happens. I want to show you guys my bump. But that is all I have for you guys. Thank you so much for chiming in. If you like this video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up for me. And if you are interested in seeing more from my family, please go ahead and hit that subscribe button. Thank you guys. Love ya.
Different.
Things okay.